Okay. Let's go. Might be a bit of a laid-back stream tonight. Not feeling like super energetic. Energetic's the wrong word. I have energy. It's just anxiety is telling me that I shouldn't be streaming, and it's taking a little bit of focus to keep going. But we will prevail. And let's make a quick change, like a really quick win that's going to make me feel better. And that is, we're going to go into our index file. And let's get this background. Yeah, I thought so. We don't have anything hooked up to it yet, but we can. Let's set the background color. Oh yeah, I forgot. We've got to change our default text color. I thought that was going to be a quick win, and it's really not. What does the Lemmings menu colour actually look like? It's all in green, isn't it? Oh, the text is in green. Do we have a picture of the menu anywhere? Doesn't help that. I guess we're getting most of them. No menus. Where's the love for menus when it comes to screenshots? Oh well, let's just go and set our text color to green. Ah, here we go. That's exactly what I wanted. I'm gonna save that because it's gonna be useful to reference. So let's set our background back to white now, just so we can see something going on. And now can I open this up in an image editor? Then I will just grab the color from the image. Oh yeah, there's still the trap there. I forgot about that. Can I save at least one of them? Yes, one will get saved. Excellent. Grab this color, that is OCC F11 by the looks of it. So actually let's put a default color in. There's our default color, and then theoretically everywhere we see that, we can just replace it with the default color. This is in generated levels, so this will actually have to be replaced with the actual value, but I can do that in a sec. So just a few that needs replacing with the hard-coded value. Excellent. Now, if we go back to our index page and set this back to black. Should just need to build a new version of it, and then everything will look better. There we go. Castle color is still black, which is a problem. Oh wait, there was one more. Okay, so that should be replaced. Close the others. Ah, there we go. I think that box shadow was all we needed. And instantly, that's looking so much better than it was. I can't believe it took me this long to do it. Look at that. Still seems to be so the trap should be the right color, but it doesn't look like it is. It's just not showing up at all. Whereas all of the other animations are the right colour. We've got the grass, we've got the ground. But grass and ground are both single character animations. Got the exit here. So exit isn't looking bad. It's very small though, so it's hard to see. It should actually be green itself. Let's zoom right into the exit. That definitely is not green. Let's just take a screenshot of this. Okay, so it might be green, it's just not coming out very well. Let's see if we can see the trap if we zoom right in on it. There's just nothing there at all. What I'm going to do is I'm going to wait until the trap activates and then I'm going to pause it. So the trap should be a block somewhere around. I've got to delete some items. It's better. Okay, so that does have an animation there. Let's get rid of this line. Let's always set the color. Oh, let's not. Let's set a default color for the page. That might be a better way of doing it. Just grab this color here. Plunk it into there. And see what we get when the trap activates now. If you've just joined us, we made our background color black and instantly everything looked so much better and so much more clear. And I'm just so pleased with it and so disappointed I didn't do it sooner. And setting that background color worked. We now have our piston trap back again. Excellent. I'm still not sure what's going on with this exit. It might just be that each individual item is just so small we can't see it properly. Might be better actually if the exit was a bit of a brighter colour. What do you think? Let's set the exit to just pure green for now. So what my plan is for the rest of the stream, I want to, yeah, the exit's slightly better like that, but it's good enough I think, we can come back to it. So yeah, the rest of the stream, I am going to lay the groundwork for having our lemmings be 2 blocks tall and 2 blocks wide, mainly because then I get more freedom in how I can animate them. At the moment they're just this looks better if it's in lowercase, really. It's supposed to go from L to K. The falling animation's pretty good. So if I can get this one to dig in time. You'll see as he falls, the flap looks pretty good, but yeah, that's the flapping, and the bomb animation I'm pretty happy with. But yeah, at the moment, I don't have a whole lot of freedom there. So what I want is to go the traditional lemmings route and have them 2 blocks wide and 2 blocks tall. Each block is 4x4 pixels, and as far as I can tell. And in fact the actual size of the sprite is 10 tall, but I think I can do it in 4. But that means I've got to change a lot. In fact, before I start that, I'm just going to edit this map and get rid of the trap. And then they can walk backwards and forwards as we're writing the code. So, basically all of the code that assumes that they are one block by one block needs to be updated. And I think a lot of that will happen in the actions. So climber. So we want to know when we're looking at whether the climber has reached an opening. We want to know not just if the tile in front of them is air, but one above that is air as well. We might need to test this out if we go to our level again. So let's just say this is going to be our gap that they can walk into, and on the other side we will have, just for example, 3 there. And then has hit ceiling. Let's rename this to cannot climb further. So we can't climb farther if the tile above is not air, and actually, by this point, we already know that there's no opening. Yeah, but we need to know Yeah, so I think so if the tile above is not air, got to work out how this is going to slot together. So, if both wall pieces are air, then climb onto ledge. Else, if no air above, then full. Else, if no wall, then full. So really, we only need to know about the wall directly in front of us. And the only reason this works is because we already check the opening before we check for whether we can climb farther or not. So if we compile this, we will make this intrepid lemming a climber. Now, what I'm hoping is they climb up, climb into that gap, and carry on. Just like that. Then they're going to turn around. Well, that tested the ceiling anyway. Now they're just going to carry on. And when they reach the other side, they should climb up to the opening but not climb into it, and instead fall back down. Nope, they climbed into it. Okay. Right, let's go into our loop and make this run a bit faster. Not the loop, the game state. So let's get a login there. And a similar log up here. I forgot the consequences of making the game that fast. Okay, so this was the opening on the right hand side. Might need to slow it down a little bit. Okay, so let's set it to like 250. Okay, so is so cannot climb further was air then ground, which is correct. Then air and ground, which is correct. Has reached opening, air and air. That is not correct. Oh, I did an ampersand. I need to do an or. Okay. So that side still works just fine. And that's how it works now that we're using the right binary operator. Excellent. That's the climbing logic done. Now we want the dig logic. So let's just say the lemming position is always going to be the top left block. Gonna look at something real quick. In fact, I think I've got a scene set up for this. I don't have music for this, oh well. So this is... They really are big, aren't they? Yeah. So... let's put this to 100%. Actually, 100% is absolutely tiny, but what we can see here is that basically this, let's clear all the guides away just for now. Now, what we've got here is, let's just say that this main blocky squarey bit is about that tall. Is 40 pixels. The lemmings should be about 10 pixels. Uh, That one's feeding 9, but there might be something hidden behind the grass. So basically, if we look back at our game over here, so basically they, if we take from I've got to switch the scene again. I think we're done with the image editing anyway. Yeah, so I don't know if the cursor is all that visible. Quite likely. It's visible enough, I think, yeah. So if we take the cursor up here as that section that was measuring just before, the lemming should be like a quarter of that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, so that's, that distance there is measured out perfectly. 10 blocks, 4 pixels a block is 40 pixels. But our lemmings are only 4 pixels high, which means instead of being a quarter, they are 10%. So they need to be way bigger. Yeah, if they're 8 pixels tall, that is 1/5 the size. And they should be 1/4. So yeah, slightly smaller, but still within margin of error. Excellent. So blocker is fine. There's very little logic here. Basher will have to be edited slightly. Let's break this out into two methods. In fact, we can just rename this one canMineTile. Okay, so now we're just yeah, that should be good. Moths flying around. Ah, go away. They seem to like me today. Is it worth doing this as two methods? It's just... I'll keep it like that for now. So what we want to do to test this one out is get back to our level here, and then for example here we can put a ceiling tile in, so it should be able to dig up to there and then not get there. Then on this side, we will put a ceiling tile in here. Oh yeah, we also want to see if this removed terrain is smart enough. So don't want to add it to moving on direction. That just needs to be minus one. Let's give it a shot. One thing I don't think I've tried is getting them to mine midway up in wall. That would be interesting. I wonder if the air tile is going to give us problems here. Think so. So let's go what animation do we give an air tile? So if it's a boundary, if it's a side, if it's an exit, if it's an air, we do nothing. So it remains the default tile with the default animation. The default animation can't be destroyed. Interesting. So do we just say that air is destructible and see what happens? I do want to add a check in that at least one of them is not air. In fact, if I make them a basher now, we can see why I want to make sure that one of them is not air, because they just dig along, and I don't think the original game let you dig through air. Okay, so that side works. That one works as well. if side dot now this is going to be better for this one method, isn't it? Wait, don't I have a method that does this? Get tile in direction. Get surrounding tile detail. Well, looks like it's time to add one. That's better. So now I can go back just to get tile detail in direction. Side is null or above is null, we're going to return false, or side.tile equals tile air and above.tile equals tile air. just take this, I guess. What is my typing today? Autocomplete, save me, please. Save me for myself. So now we just get rid of can mine tile. Let's call it can mine tile because that's what it was called before, and it'll make the committee easier. Okay, let's give it a while. Is the correct behavior for trying to mine pure air. Don't currently have a test for mining ground above and air below, but we can probably assume it'll work. Unless we've got a logic bug somewhere. Side null, side tile above tile, side animation above animation. Looks like it's all good. Beginning to wonder. Is it just the actions we need to do? I guess we will find out in a little bit, but I am going to take a quick break and I'll be back in a sec. Okay, we're back. Now, I have realized a slight problem in that I'm doing all of these calculations based on the lemming's position. How many times do I access this thing? 54 times. That's going to be a problem. Wonder if Assemblyscript can handle getters. Might just give it a go. This is vendor level, vendor lemming. Okay, that's fine. Let's give a getter a go. Now we see whether everything is fine or everything is broken. Everything is fine. It seems to be fine. Interesting. So, don't know if I explained why I did that. I might have just got distracted trying to do it. When the lemming is a 4x4 animation texture tile sprite thing, I can't any longer describe its position as a single point. Because if, for example, I said, okay, its position's going to be its bottom right, and then it came over here and started to climb, I can put logic in to handle that, but it's going to clip into the wall halfway before any of that happens, and that's not going to look good. But what I can do is... let's just see... yeah, this might have to be... so... anyway, one thing at a time. To do when lemmings are 2x2 blocks, modify the X position returned here to always represent the outer edge based on what direction it's facing. Well, not the outer edge, the forward edge. So, because we just put that clone in there, and because we're going to be modifying the position, what we actually want to do is... put another note in... and they're 2x2 blocks, modify the X position set here to account for the fact that it may be one off based on what direction it's facing. Okay, good. I'm not speaking much, am I? Should do more of that. Unfortunately, there's not much to say. Just doing some refactoring. I'm failing at typing quite a bit. I'm also increasing the amount of boilerplate code, which means at some point I should think about refactoring or adding a method to lemming class to increase left and right direction. So, you know, this would be a really good time for me to talk to chat. Say, how are you doing? How's it going for you? What do you want to see from the game? But there doesn't seem to be any chat right now. There is exactly one viewer, and that is quite likely, or that's definitely me. Because I'm previewing the stream. but it looks like we're done with the refactoring now. Let's just see if any of that broke anything horrendously. Yes, yes it did. Okay, where is our fooling code? We didn't even modify that. The fact that we didn't modify that is quite likely the problem. Okay. That's a bit better. So we need to test out various different things. Okay, those seem to work as much as can be expected. Climber should probably test that out. Climber is not climbing. I don't know if that's because it got trapped in the brick or because the climbing is broken. You can be a climber, you can also have an umbrella. A block in place. Nope, climbing is not working. Both of those are fine. That's fine. All of this is terrible code. It's causing, like, this causes a clone of the vec2, and this causes a clone of the vec2, and it's no good. So what other skills do we have? Building, done all of those, should be fine. Okay, climbing now seems to work, and I don't suspect umbrella will be broken at all because that's a slight modification of the fallen code. Yes, that's fine. And now there's a lot to commit. So, basher, blocker, there's nothing we need to do here. It's the walking, I think, that references the blocker. Builder. So, can build next tile. In fact, do we import anything? Nothing major. So this needs to be modified in exactly the same way. A 2-space air gap. Onto a brick tile if there's a 2-space gap. Okay, so going to have to modify the map a bit. So we kind of want a row there that we can test under. Should not be able to build there, but we should be able to build here, just not very far. So what did we change? Can build other direction. Can move on to. So we want building in the other direction's a bit difficult, isn't it? Okay, let's run it and test it. So So they should not be able to build there. Wait for you to get a couple in before I tell you to build. Okay, good. Can build there for exactly one block. And you can climb onto it. So this should prevent building in the other direction. Seems like it kind of did, but I think there's something a bit off with the code. Let's see what it does when it builds for a little bit before that happens. Not good. Looks like none of them can build more than one high before turning around. So what it's supposed to do is build, move. That'll be it. Still referencing lemming.position, which meant that it thought, well, it was just looking at a block two below where it should be. Hello there, if you're just joining us. We are currently going through our Lemmings game and changing a load of code to deal with the fact that pretty soon they will have a bigger texture. So we're just changing things to cope with that and testing it out. That's better. Now when it hits the wall, they should turn around and start building in the other direction. Now we just need to test. Just need to test what happens when they turn around, but there's no room to build in the other direction. They should just stop building, I think, and carry on as they were, just start walking. That's about as good as I can expect, I think. There might be a slight bug there, but it's not one that I'm going to worry too much about. Climber, I think, yeah, we've already done the climber. Digger. Can mine down. So we want to check what is below and what is below to the left. So if either of these are null, then we can't dig down. And if both of them are air, then we can't dig down. They shouldn't be air, because we already handled fooling, but we'll check anyway. Then we just check that both blocks can be destroyed. So let's get rid of these mods. Then we want to do something like, say here, we put in a boundary, and maybe over here, Actually, I don't even think we can test the bit where it's falling, so let's just test what we got. Number one, we forgot to destroy the extra tile. Number two, we actually dug in the wrong place. Did I miss that? Honestly. So here, that's better. Perfect. And also perfect. Next up, fooling. Make sure that there's two blocks where two blocks under you. Umbrella, that's fine. Handle fooling and remove from game. And handle falling does not need to be updated. Oh yeah, we need to update our level slightly. So if we take this for example, they should walk right over it. But this they should fall down. fact, if we put one there, then they should get trapped on it. Pretty much. So is there anything else? Is fooling done? Handle fooling? Handle climbing? All done. Now mining. I don't know. We need to do anything for mining. I'm pretty sure mining already takes out 2 blocks. Might have to leave that one until we get the new animations in and see if it looks odd. Actually, no, that's only taking out one. Yeah. So what have we got left? Mining, umbrella, and walking. Okay, mining definitely needs to be edited because these now can't fall through because it's only one wide. So, miner. So, same deal. So we no longer need to supply facing direction. Just need down. And we need to make sure that this is replaced correctly. So we know that neither of them are air blocks. Or at least one of them isn't air blocks, because the one directly below it. Actually, best check that anyway. So, this one, let's put a couple of spaces there, then let's put a ground there. So what we want to do is start mining here and make sure they don't mine. And then we can start mining here and make sure they do, and start mining about here and make sure it stops. That did not stop. Yeah, we also need to remove the drain directly below. Do we want directly below? Yes, what we want is actually Let's give it a go. That's minus equals, that needs to be plus equals. That's why the check failed. And I guess we need to duplicate this. It's probably going to look very weird at the moment, but once the new animations are in place, it should look a lot better. Good. I think one of the terrain indestructible checks failed. It's also not looking like it's making a wide enough entrance. So we want to move one below. One to the right and two to the right. Let's test this. With a bit bigger target to hit for the indestructible stuff. That destruction pattern is actually looking better now. Definitely think I'm going to need to modify it a bit more. Yeah, it is three across, isn't it? Maybe I need one to the right as well. I rebuild that. Don't think I did I? It's not destroying that last section. Maybe I need to handle the fooling after the mine. Maybe I don't need this at all. Because if it's air under both of them, it says it can't mine it, and then it starts walking, and then it starts falling. Maybe slightly better. No. Well, slightly better, but not really good enough. It's because I'm moving forward twice for everyone I mine down. So let's only move across one and see how that handles it. That's much cleaner. I like that. Sorted. So now there's just the walk class. I'm gonna rename this can walk up one block. So we want the tile in the facing direction. The one in the facing direction and up. So got this, so tile forward equals tile air and tile forward tile above. Equals tile air. So that's normal walking forwards. Tile forward is not air. And tile above is air. And tile two above is air. Actually, I need to do something like this. So if I just have like steps there, they should walk up it and walk down, and then normal bricks. Right, like that. So they should be able to walk up all of that, and then walk up that and walk up that, and then not be able to walk up the wall. I should probably as well have a test there for just the two blocks. Got one too many there. Okay. Nope, it doesn't want to. Yeah, so this needs to be if tile does not equal tile air. Yeah. So if there's an air tile followed by a ground tile, then you're walking downstairs. Used in one place. Yeah, so walk up, walk down, or stay the same level. Still doesn't want to do it. So, it should be fairly simple. If the tile in front of you is air, and so this bit definitely works. Otherwise, so if this bit is not air. Do this in a simpler way. Plus two, not minus two. Of course, that's going to come out wrong. He's trying to burrow into the ground instead of walk upstairs. Go, just walking up those. real test is, how does it handle the bricks? Can't handle them. Going to have to add an edge case in. So if right in front of you is air, but above you is brick, then you can still go forward. If forward is brick, yeah, that should do for now. Where's the ever? There might be more edge cases to do with bricks, but this is the one that's immediately obvious to me. Lemming should be able to walk through staircases from the other direction, from behind, so to speak. Let's have a look at what else it's doing. Is falling handle falling? We've done. Exit is fine. It's looking like the walking through the stairs is fine now. Oh wait, they're never going to get here, are they? Okay, let's redo the map just for... Can walk on next tile if you can't. Climbing we've done. Turning around is working. This bit's working, so that's walking all done. What changes did I make to the map? Okay, yeah, that's fine. Let's reset the map as close to possible as default. seems to be it. So, what else could we possibly have? Traps. I guess a trap should activate if any part of the lemming is on the trap. But then, once we do the forward motion, really it's only going to be... That should sort itself out. Yeah, I think that's done. Okay. Well, thank you to everyone who popped into the stream throughout the evening. Really appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed yourselves. And anyone still watching, whatever you happen to be going on to do this evening or for the rest of the day, I hope you have a really good one. If you want to come chat in between streams, I have a Discord in my profile. If you want to be notified of when the stream happens, there's a follow and a notify thing in the profile. I'm sure you know where to find it, if that's what you want. But yeah, as I said, have a good one, and see you 9 p.m. UK time tomorrow.